I just wanted to be an actor. I was funny. I was always the class clown, and I always made people laugh. So I guess what I'm saying is, if it's written down, I can be funny. I love working. I mean, that's it. I mean, I love being able to be a working actor. And what do I dislike about it? I don't like the downtime that, you know, actors do go through. When you finish a job, you know, you're out of work. And so that part of it takes some adjustment. Does the instability of an acting career scare you? Not anymore. You know, I mean, it did in the beginning. And it's just, but it's like sort of the instability of life. You know, a young lawyer doesn't know what's going to happen either. So nobody gets, you know, a free lunch. Go to work when they call me in, whatever time that is. Hair and makeup, yes. Actors do wear makeup. Not that they want to, but the lighting and stuff makes it possible. If it's early in the morning, they say, what would you like for breakfast? Which nobody does for me in any other part of my life. And then they say, we're ready for you on the set. And I love it. I mean, I love it. You see the crew. These are people you know, you work with now for 6 years, most of them. Tony and I sit down and we start playing with the scene. We have never said, here's what I'll do, here's what you'll do, here's what... We're both in sync with each other's rhythm, and then we start playing. And pretty much what we start off doing at the top evolves and gets honed into what you see when you watch the show, like you'll see in a little while, half an hour, 10 minutes. You know, the writers don't write Kroger scenes just because they're Kroger scenes. They write the scenes that have something to do with the story. And I think if there were ever a situation where it would be helpful to the story to have Monk and his colleagues come to therapy, then they would write it. These scenes are written letter perfect. We've never had any need to wing it or try to improv. What you see is what they've written. And if it feels like improv, it's a credit to how well it's written and, if I may say, how naturally we play it. Now, I had a scene a couple weeks ago where I had a line that I couldn't, for some reason I couldn't get it. It just, you know, sometimes it happens. And Tony cracked up and started laughing and, you know, I guess those would qualify as bloopers. I'd love it if they had them. Thank you.
When John Henry was a little baby, he sat on his mama's knee. He picked up a hammer, a piece of steel, said, "Hammer will be the death of me. Lord, Lord, hammer will be the death of me." Yes!
Don't think it goes unnoticed. It means a great deal to me in doing this part that, you know, you can act, but if you're doing it at home in front of the mirror, nobody knows it. So the fact that you guys are there and you know it and you come up with these great insights and these questions makes it very special to me, and I appreciate it.